Okay. All right, everybody, welcome to the City of Sweetwater Special Commission meeting. Meeting date Wednesday, November 16, 2016, at 8 p.m. Commission Chambers, 500 Southwest 109 Avenue. Roll call, Madam Clerk.
Clerk, no, the absence of Mayor Lopez, Commissioner Maroño, and Commissioner Diaz.
Okay, please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance and the invocation.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Anybody want to say a prayer? Okay. Lord, please help us to make our decisions that are good for the citizens of Sweetwater. And please pray for all those that are injured. Anna Frometa, who's come back from an operation, and she's finally just got home, and wishing her well and speedy recovery. Please pray for our troops that are overseas defending our freedom, and our first responders, and for all our citizens that they may have health. In your name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Okay, do we have any public comments? Anybody? Can you please put your state your name and address for the record, sir?
Yes. My name is Jose, last name Mejia. My address is 10634 Southwest 5th Street, Miami, Florida, 33174. I wanted to ask a couple questions regarding number five, an ordinance creating amnesty period. Mr. Bourguignon, what exactly is this this ordinance? Can you brush up on it exactly?
Yes, this is we right now have this amnesty period going on in the city of Sweetwater, and it was done. It started last year, and it ends in December, and we're wanting to
extend
it for about a year. And I've had some recommendations by some people to change a couple of things on it.
Maybe the duration of the extension.
No, not at this time.
Okay. Now let me ask you something. Out of curiosity, is it in fact not the case that Commissioner Diaz would be benefiting from this amnesty?
I have no idea about any of that. This is
because it says creating a limited exception from civil penalties and liens for building code violations, et cetera, et cetera. So civil penalties in particular.
That's something that I'm going to address.
Okay. Very well. Very well. And out of curiosity, in the past 12 months, aside from last year, we've never ever touched bases on this matter in regards to our city, right? With as far as an ordinance creating amnesty, we've never really touched. It hasn't been a practice of touching that that ordinance.
We had a moratorium before that. Then we had an amnesty, and that I know of, that's it.
Okay.
But this has been 50 years in the city.
Touching back on
75 years.
Touching back on the prayer thing, you had prayed for the best interests of our city and its residents. Wouldn't you agree that maybe perhaps putting on as an item for a resolution, setting a moratorium, what you had just specified, which I guess would prevent us as a city from doing certain things in regards to a topic, and we can specify Diaz's and the whole purpose of that.
Wait. You're rambling on. I have no idea what you're talking
about. I'm getting there if you let me finish. The whole purpose of that would be, instead of creating an ordinance, amnesty period, extending the one that was already here, and we already see the litigation going on and the fact that the case was practically already done and decided on, I think we shouldn't touch that until you know, that issue's resolved completely, because all we're going to do then is put our city and its residents back in the hook for litigation back and forth. I mean, wouldn't you agree or whatnot?
No, I think you're talking apples and oranges. This has nothing to do with any litigation.
So then you tell me, if you pass this ordinance today, you don't think Lucy Castro's attorneys are going to object to that? Or
I have no idea. This has nothing to do with any of that. I don't know where you're coming up with this.
Because I just don't understand how convenient every month when we have a commission meeting, you bring an item before the commission in regards that would benefit Mr. Diaz. So, I mean, it's kind of difficult to not understand that.
That's your opinion?
My opinion, very well.
That's all I can talk about.
Thank you, that'll be all.
Yes, a couple of points, just for clarification, Mr. President. The prior amnesty already expired. So this is basically bringing that period once again. Exactly. And relative to the issues with Commissioner Diaz and the outstanding litigation, frankly, to the extent that he may have had a civil fine because of a code violation, or if the city had placed a lien, what this item does only gives him an opportunity, just like any other citizen, to go ahead and be able to come into compliance with the current standards in the code, and not basically allow the accrual of those penalties. I don't think that there are any civil fines or outstanding liens. I know we have George from Court Enforcement here, and he can explain that. But I don't think that property has, as far as we know right now, any pending fines or liens. So I don't think this is anything that would kind of impact or even anything germane to the litigation, which has to do with a variance and that expired, and that is something separate and apart. I don't think it has anything to do, in my opinion, with the Diaz matter. This is basically, again, allowing those homeowners that may have violations or pending liens the ability to come into compliance and not allow that accrual of those civil fines. Because what this commission sought the last time that it had this item was basically bringing as many homeowners into compliance with the current requirements in the code as possible.
Right.
So I know that there's still a lot of outstanding issues out there. So it's basically attempting to do that, to again have a lot of these homeowners come into compliance. The Diaz matter is about a variance. As far as I understand it, nothing pending with any fines or any liens, but I will let Mr. Vega mention that.
Really simple. Just to show you that this applies to everybody. We all listen. It's just like if we vote for the trash to be changed. It affects us because we have a trash. Now it's my turn. I think your time's up. The mayor's taking advantage of this. Commissioner Yanyo's taking advantage of it. This is not... They're regular residents. Everybody can take advantage of these kind of things that we're trying to help out the community.
Just to clarify then, so this ordinance by no way, shape, or form would this circumvent the judge's order in regards to that litigation?
No,
that's what I want to know.
The judge's order.
It is my opinion that honestly,
you're not familiar with the judge's order, but you're a commissioner. You should know, because I'm sure you've seen how the cost of the litigation is going.
Right.
That's
but I'm
important.
Not
here,
so I can't interpret it.
If I may. It is my opinion that this, in relative to the litigation in place, this does not confer any benefit to Commissioner Diaz, because again, I want to make sure that we put her on the record. Unless he has any outstanding fines or any pending liens, this only affects those. It doesn't go into the hard litigation or variances or any of that nature.
I just spoke to the code enforcement official a while ago, and that was exactly one of the issues that we talked about, because we learned from the past experience that they can't levy fines on some of the people, and they wait for the year. They go ahead and wait another year before they have to get a fine for it, or a lien or anything like that. So we talked about changing some of this, and that's what we talked about earlier. So I was going to bring that up now.
Commissioner Bergignon said he stated that you stand to benefit from this ordinance as well. Like any other citizen?
Like any other citizen. I already did my plans. I already put everything in order.
The mayor did the same thing.
The mayor did the same thing.
Let me just go ahead and make sure that things are clear.
Yeah, because she can't be able to vote on something if she stands to benefit on. That's already done in the past. That's what you were trying to say. I understand very well.
There was a prior amnesty period that was approved by the commission. I believe it expired just a few months ago.
Yes.
Many homeowners avail themselves of the opportunity to come in, and take care of those fines and remove those any liens as long as they came into compliance. Again, this is a vehicle for code compliance. This is what this is. And any homeowners, whether it is any employee or any resident, he can go ahead and do that.
It's just a coincidence.
But this is as it pertains to fines and liens. And so the only way that those things are then removed is if they come into compliance. If they don't come into compliance, fines and penalties, all of that remains.
Through the chair.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, I don't know if people old enough in the city hall here remember, can reconfirm what I'm going to say, but I was not even the commissioner, not even dreamed to be a commissioner those days. I was sitting there during the administration of Manny Maroño. There was 1 year of a moratorium to allow citizens to come to compliance. Maybe Vega, if he was here, remember, and to come to compliance, avoiding the fines and the liens. If I remember correctly, it was also 1 year. Madam Chair, do you remember something to that effect?
Yes, I do.
Okay.
And in essence, Commissioner, this word for word is the same piece of legislation that was adopted by this commission last year. For a period of 12 months, the 12 months expires. The commission now is considering providing an additional 12 months. I don't think it had any impact whatsoever the prior 12-month period, which is exactly word for word what you have here. I don't think it had any impact on the Diaz matter at all. I don't expect it to have any impact at all because it's the same. Is the same again,
but it does have, could have impact on the revenues of the code enforcement department, correct? By way
okay,
of,
I think your time is up already, sir. Yeah.
Would it not by sir? Way of putting that ordinance and not finding
sir,
people?
Your time is up.
It's actually code compliance, not code enforcement. I believe that's the new name. And the key, no, and I'm saying that because what it's underscored is the term compliance. What we see, what the city seeks is compliance with court requirements more above everything else.
Very well. Thank you for your time.
All right. Anybody else? Sir, if you can keep your name and address for the record, please.
Certainly. Commissioner, my name is Paul Savage. I have law offices at 2121 Ponce de Leon Boulevard, Suite 900 in Coral Gables, Florida. I'm here tonight representing Lucy Castro, who lives at 611 Southwest 104th. Here in the city of Sweetwater. I think that your city attorney adequately covered many of the concerns that I was here to raise, so I will not go over it again. I know your time is limited. I did want to just reiterate and repeat with him for the record very briefly that this is the same legislation that the city enacted approximately 1 year ago.
Word for word.
That to characterize your remarks, you do not understand that this would impact Mr. Diaz's particular situation or property or case, that this legislation is aimed at fines and liens having to do with fines. And I'll note for the record that the city attorney is acknowledging in the affirmative, and that it does not have to do with it does not appear to have to do with Mr. Diaz or his issues, which have to do with an expired variance and the kinds of enforcement that would come into play in that situation.
And that is correct. And if this legislation would have conferred any benefit, I think that we would have seen that during the prior time frame where this legislation was in place. But just to make sure that the record is clear, I would also ask Mr. Vega, code compliance director, to make sure that as it relates to the Diaz property, that there are no fines or liens, because those will be the only things impacted under this legislation.
Thank you again for allowing me the time. Thank you. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
Good evening, commissioners. No, at this time, there is no fines nor liens on Mr. Diaz's property from our code compliance department.
Thank you.
And if I may, may I address the little bit of my concerns that I have?
Well, we're going to talk about the item in a minute.
Okay,
the public comments.
Okay.
2 minutes, I won't be talking to you. Okay, anybody else? Okay, let the record show that nobody else is stepping forward for public comment. We're going to item 5. An ordinance creating amnesty period, creating a limited exception from civil penalties and liens for building code violations upon a homeowner's compliance with the building code and or additional criteria, providing severability, inclusion in the code, and an effective date. First reading and first public hearing, Commissioner Virgilian. This is a public hearing. Anybody that wishes to come forth on this item, please do so now.
Good evening, Commissioners, Mr. Attorney, Madam Clerk. I'm here to speak.
Address for the record.
500 Southwest 109 Avenue. I'm here to speak in behalf of the ordinance that is being presented here tonight. I have a concern in the time frame that it's being given to a resident to comply, the year's time. We have noticed in the past that when we go out and we investigate a complaint and we find that there is a violation, a building violation, we give them 30 days to come in and try to comply, try to get the building department, get some permits. If that doesn't occur, then we go ahead and issue the fine. But when you talk to the resident or the property owner, you explain to them that they have, these are the steps that they need to take, or else these are consequences that will happen, that will motivate them to come in and try to get the process done within that time frame. If you give them a year's time to do that, then that may prolong them from coming in, because all they're going to do is receive a warning of violation, and they may not continue. Now, there may be issues of life safety issues that probably could be seen at the time that we go out there and we look at it, but there's other circumstances where we can't see the life safety issues. Now, my concern is, if something were to happen, and I know I asked the city attorney on this, but if something were to happen and a life is lost because of a fire or something that we didn't see inside of a wall, would the city be liable for that or be accountable for it?
As it relates to life safety issues, Commissioner, there is no... There is no time frame provided that would allow them to just to ignore a life safety condition. No, those have to be addressed not only by the property owner, but also the you know, code compliance need to make sure that those life safety conditions are improved. And this amnesty period wouldn't relieve a homeowner from their obligation to cure those conditions. Or the code compliance department to make sure that those conditions are cured.
My suggestion is, and my opinion is, that I think the 1 year's time, it's very long time for them to come into compliance. I think if the time frame is shortened, will be something more reasonable to try to make them come in. And if they don't comply within that time, then other procedures may be taken. Thank you very much.
Okay. Okay. Wait. Let the record reflect nobody else is coming forward. Public hearing is now closed. Okay.
You made a motion?
Yes, sir.
Second.
And second by Commissioner Barreto. Roll call, Madam Clerk. Anybody want to say anything? No?
Motion by Commissioner Yanio.
Second. Now, hold on a second. So, from what you said, Mr. Attorney, it doesn't believe that if he goes to give somebody a ticket, a warning, and he has 30 days to, like a normal time frame, you have 30 days to comply. I think, is there a week to comply?
There's 30 days to comply, and if within that time frame, if you can't comply, we can give them, they can ask for another extension of another 30 days. So you've got a total of 60 days before anything, and it starts rolling out any fines.
Which is, that's the normal way that it works. Okay, so the way that this is written, can the person say, well, I don't have to wait 60 days, I got a year to comply?
They have a year to be able to come in at some point during that year and initiate the compliance process. Okay, until they take affirmative action and come in and try to avail themselves of this amnesty, those fines and those liens are outstanding.
Okay,
so they are not relieved.
Okay,
it is basically a year for them to at any point during that year to come and attempt to cure the issue. If they don't come in...
And they're caught, they still have to go through the regular process.
They have to... Well, they would have that year. They would have that year to be able to come in and try to cure that. But if a fine is issued, in other words, the city inspector does not... Nothing precludes him from finding a condition that violates the code and issuing whatever warning or fine he has to. Nothing precludes you from that.
So we can issue if they don't comply within that time frame, we can still issue the fine.
You move as you usually do.
Correct.
The amnesty period allows them the ability to not have an accrual of fines
or lien, or
the placement of a lien, okay, as long as they are complying with the requirements of this ordinance, which, you know, requires plans and require, you know, basically compliance with the code. They have to make that condition compliant with the code. If they don't do that...
Okay, so we don't have to do anything. Okay.
I'm gonna go ahead and talk with the director to make sure that we don't have any holes in there. Exactly. Yeah. So we'll make sure that we...
Okay, roll call, Madam Clerk.
Yes.
Thank you.
But we don't have any unintended
Commissioner Suarez?
Yes.
Commissioner Duazo?
Yes.
Commissioner Yanio?
Yes.
Commissioner Barreto?
Yes.
President Berganian?
Yes. Thank you. Okay. Item 6, a resolution of the City Commission of the City of Sweetwater, Florida, establishing a temporary early separation incentive program for police officers, directing the city clerk to send a copy of this resolution to all members of Congress and providing for an effective date. Commissioner Yanis.
Mr. President, if I may.
Yes, sir.
There is a Scrivener's error, which you notice in the title. So although you just read the item and you're going to be able to discuss the item, that title has to be amended. So a substitute item must be provided in lieu of this particular resolution. At this point, however, I would invite you to discuss the issue. You read the item into the record, but just be mindful that a substitute item needs to be provided, amending the title, correcting the Scrivener's error.
Okay, I just want to mention that in the past, every time we have a temporary early separation, which is an early retirement for police officer, a resolution took place. We have resolution 4037 and 3807 was appropriately bring over to the commission for approval, and also the knowledge of waive and release agreement was attached to it for the commission actually to review and look at it, and it has been done in the past. At this point, it was never brought anything to the commission. I asked Chief Ventura, which we had a meeting, the pension board had a meeting on October 18. I attended, and I make very clear and ask if this kind of agreement was supposed to be bringing in this package. It was going to be presented to the commission. Mr. Ventura replied that it was an administrative function. So it means like we didn't have anything to say. I don't agree with it because the resolution have to be approved by the commission, not by the administration. This have done in the past, and I believe that's the right way to do it. If I'm saying something different, please correct me.
Let me state the following, Commissioner, and forgive me if my answer is going to be a little protracted, but I think the more information I give you, the better I serve you. Relative to the resolutions that you mentioned that are for prior instances where the commission approved an early retirement incentive plan for a period of time for city employees, timing is an issue. What do I mean by that? Those resolutions were approved by the commission at some point during the budget year. Okay? So what it means is the commission, as a matter of policy, approves or determines the period of time, the window of time that employees can avail themselves of this retirement incentive. It approves what benefits are going to be conferred in consideration of that early retirement. And it provides all the parameters for that program. Once it's approved, at some point later in the year, whether it's in the, at the mid-year level or at the end of the year, the budget is then reconciled along with any other items, any new items that took place during the budget year, you know, to make sure that you have a balanced budget. Your budget is reconciled at the end. The timing for this is a little different because this commission contemplated in its budget that it was going to have an early retirement incentive program. I believe some savings were estimated and incorporated into the budget. So that part, as opposed to previous years, which is done later in the year at some point, that was done first. What the commission has not determined is all the parameters other than 15 years of service, which is part of the mayor's budget message that was approved by this commission, and the figure, I believe $170,000 as estimated savings by implementing an early retirement incentive program. Other than that, no determination has been made by this commission as to what benefits to provide those employees that qualify and wish to avail themselves of that retirement incentive, what benefits are going to be conferred to those people in consideration for an early retirement. So that determination has not been made by the commission. If there are any other parameters, if the only parameter is the 15 years of service, then the commission has already acted on that. And again, it contemplated an early retirement plan. What the early retirement plan has to be, the commission has not made a determination as of yet. I know that the administration has specific information relative to the individuals that qualify as to what the plan should look like, and I believe that they have met with most of you, if not all of you, and disclosed that. A determination has yet to be made by this commission, and that's the best way I can answer your question, Commissioner.
Yes, I got to say. Okay, first of all, I'm not going to get into political mudslinging, but everybody that kind of understands what has happened here with this item goes back to trying to establish something that might cause litigation, like some people have brought up. Instead of doing it the proper way in the proper channels, and for some reason, they signed agreements, they came up with numbers, knowing full well that it had to come to the commission. And I think that this is all taking advantage of basically the situation we have here with a strong mayor, form of government. But nonetheless, I think the commission has a duty and responsibility to not only be made aware, but at the same time, believe it or not, protect the officers that want to retire. And I think that a couple of things that have happened here really doesn't protect them. The way things were written, the way things were done, and from what I could see when I spoke to the chief, now I'm very disappointed. The mayor, the chief, and Ralph Ventura didn't show up to talk about this or even say anything about it. And I think that shows a lot for, at the end of the day, if they really care about these officers. But with that being said, I think that there's a lot of numbers that the chief gave me. He told me he wanted nothing to do. He didn't know about the legality of anything, but that he just wanted to show me the numbers, and he showed me the numbers. And as far as I'm concerned, I pretty much agree with the savings that we're going to get, the benefits that are going to be provided by the pension board and by the city. Now, I'm concerned with some of the items. For example, they're giving out 7 years to the officers as far as insurance, and the way it worked out with the four officers, I believe, that took advantage of it, in my mind, estimating the amounts, it works out, because it really comes out to about 3.5 years per officer, which is usually the going rate of retirement. But since two of them are taking it, so and some are taking seven, it works out in the numbers. And I have no problem with this. The only problem I have is that it has to be done correctly. And I think that we're coming to Thanksgiving, we're coming to Christmas. It's going to be hard to put meetings together. I think that we should, the administration should come forward with the exact numbers and days that they want, and that we have a chance to mull it over. I don't know if every commissioner got the information I got from them. And it can be confusing because there's about seven or so officers that can apply to this. And the window would have to be reopened.
No, Mr. President,
There was no window, but the one that they provided. And I've spoken to some of the officers, and they told them that if they didn't do it by October, whatever it was, 28th, that they're out, that it's not being offered to them. And I don't understand why, because there's no window. So we have to provide a window, which I think should be, as stated in which Commissioner Yanyo brought, from the 1st to the 31st of December, to be in that window and be able to sign the agreement or contract or whatever it is. I think it all has to be ratified by the commission. It has to be signed by the mayor as far as an agreement, which they weren't there. Establish exactly what insurance they have exactly to match the insurance that the other officers are getting. Because what if they just put insurance? And at the end of the day, they tell them, look, it's Obamacare instead of the regular insurance. You know, so there's things that protect both sides. It has to be done right. What else did I have? Like on their contract, they wrote it was the same or similar insurance instead of saying equal to regular insurance that they had. 15 years of service is fine. I think it should be to read 15 continuous years, because, and we also have to state that in this department, because I don't know specifically if there's an officer that maybe had 5 years at another department, then 10 here. I don't know. Because I'm just trying to cover.
It contemplates service in the Sweetwater.
Right, so it'd be continuous, 15-year service. What else? The window and the date. And does the insurance include their family or not? Because if they're getting the insurance for their family here now, I would think that they want it for the rest of the family, and it include that and be stated in writing so that they're covered completely. And if we can put this administration can give the numbers to the commissioners, I mean, to the rest of them and talk to them. I don't know if they have or not.
No.
So we could come together. And I think if we could, the way I was looking at it, because I kind of want to get this done fast, is if we can have a meeting next Tuesday. Because to vote on it right now, not having that information,
and
not even here to.
And as I mentioned, the item also has to be corrected.
Right.
The meeting's it's going to be on the 28th, the following week, not next Tuesday.
Okay, and then the 28th of November.
Mm-hmm. Next meeting.
What day of the week is that?
The resolution is sent.
And it's only one reading, right? It's a resolution?
It's a resolution. You do have a meeting on November 28th, as the Madam Clerk stated.
For the, to the chair?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. On that day, are we going to be saying, you know, based on all the commissioners?
I think.
So how many years is we're going to be giving for the insurance? And how many years are we going to give for the pension contribution?
I think that's what each commissioner should get the numbers from the
and
administration.
Then each one can
and everybody
propose.
Make up their mind and we talk about it at the meeting. Now,
okay.
From what I gathered, the way I explained it, it should be something of around 3.5 years average per officer. So if you have, from what it looks like, some can get seven, some can get zero. I don't know how we could word it legally, Mr. Attorney, so that
My recommendation would be, Mr. President, since it is my understanding that should the commission approve this early retirement incentive program, if some of the officers that qualify opt out of the benefit of, you know, receiving health insurance, as the way it is worded now, I think they have the opportunity to opt out. I urge you to stay away from averages. I think the best way is to provide whatever benefits are going to be approved by the commission, and with language allowing those officers to opt out of health insurance if they so desire. I think that's the cleanest way to do it. Which means that if there are any officers that opt out receiving health insurance, then the city does not have to pay for that. So that is an additional savings. But that would be the way I suggest wording it. Giving the opportunity to opt out and spelling out specifically what benefits are being conferred.
So those four or five items, and I'll give you another one here. On the bottom of one of the plans, it says this calculation does not reflect potential increases in pay for promotions that may occur to fill positions of members retiring under the window. So if we got five staff guys leaving, then we're going to promote five other guys, and that doesn't include that amount of money. That's something that's not going to be a savings. That's going to hurt the savings, bottom line. And in a letter from the mayor's office with the PBA, and what was interesting is that they signed all these contracts and stuff before they got a letter from the PBA saying that they're okay with it. But they said also here that the net savings, which constituted an intricate part of balancing our budget, will then be used to resolve the pending grievance and reinstate laid off officers to repay the pension fund over 7 years. But the pending grievance is solely for the pension fund? There's other grievances. How is it going to cost us? How is it going to be used? What money is going to be used for what? So there's little wording issues that can cost us a lot of money. So if the administration were here, I guess we could, but.
Through the chair.
Yes, sir.
I agree with you. I wish that the administration be here so we could have a clear, transparent debate, but they are not here. So I want to pass some information. Even though I would like them to be here in case they don't agree with what I'm going to say, but this is what they told me at the meeting I had with them related to the retirement plan with Chief Diaz, with Mr. Ventura, and Mayor Aquiles Carmona. I asked that specific question that you just touched up. Is the payroll of the officers that are going to be taking the place of the one that are retiring, payroll and benefits, calculated into the savings? The answer was yes, it's incorporated there, it's incorporated into the equation, the cost of the officer coming in to take the...
Right, but they're just regular officers. So now, if you have three people that are in command staff, for example, I don't know how many, but there's one or two that say they're in command staff. Well, now they got to get, let's say the person's a lieutenant. Now they got to get a regular officer and make him a lieutenant. And they're not calculating for that. They're calculating for him as a regular officer, not as a lieutenant, which might be, I don't know, $10,000 more, $15,000 more. But over 7 years, that's $70,000.
Yeah.
And if you got three people like that, that's $210,000. So that's why the wording, and they even wrote it there.
That's why I wish they were here so they can talk about that right now.
And just to be clear to the officers, because we know most of these people for years and they're friends of ours and they're doing a great job as officers. But the tendency has been politically here to, after these kind of things happen, now we're the bad guys that we're trying to not agree with everything they just laid out and just go along and lay down. If they want to retire and it's going to cause a savings to the city and they've done their job, I have no problem with it. But let's do it right. So what I would like to do is refer this to have a meeting on the 28th, I believe it is then?
There's a meeting for a budget amendment on the 28th.
So if the administration gets their ducks in a row by the 28th and talks to each commissioners and has all those numbers, most of them are planning on retiring December 1st.
November 30th.
Oh, November 30th? Well, you have 2 days. If they do everything right, then we're good to go.
The window as of now, however, it's December 1st. I can amend that if the commission directs me as I provide the corrected item.
Oh, one more day.
But as of now, it's the window is December 1st to the 31st.
So we can defer this item to the 28th would be the easiest way to do it?
I have to submit a substitute item, so we can go ahead and just withdraw this item.
Okay.
And correct that item, and I will incorporate some of the things that were mentioned here for your consideration in the new resolution.
To the chair, yes, the 28th, actually, we're going to be discussing how many years are we going to be in favor?
Yes, I would think after what we just said, the administration is going to come back and the police chief is going to come back and say, look, this is the complete plan now with your window from the first to and the things that we just asked for here. Okay. They got the recording. The things we asked for here, which is pretty much what they had, but just
I think done correctly. They make a decision.
And we make a decision.
Okay.
Okay, so you withdraw the item for today?
Yes, and I'm going to be dropped today, and it's going to be placed on the 28th?
On the 28th.
Okay.
It's going to go out on Tuesday.
Okay. Let me ask one quick question. Does this necessarily have to be an agreement or a contract? Is there any technicality to that? Because I didn't see the mayor's signature on it. It just said agreement, and if they sign it, it's magically okay. That's what the paper says.
I'm not certain what you're referring to, Commissioner, because I have not seen any agreements.
Okay.
The chief has copies.
They gave me copies, but
I'm sorry. I have not.
Okay.
I have not seen those. They have not been provided to me.
Okay. So that's it. Item 7, adjournment.
Move.
Second by Commissioner Barreto. Second by Commissioner Suarez. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.